Son, and of the and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. O God of grace and mercy, we give thanks for your loving kindness shown to Carol and to all your servants, who, having finished their course in faith, now rest from their labors. Grant that we also may be faithful unto death and receive the crown of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. First reading is from Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And a reading from Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8 through 9. For by grace you have been saved through faith. This is not your own doing. It is the gift of God, not a result of works, so that no one may boast. And a reading from John chapter 3, verses 16 through 17. Please rise for the reading of the Holy Gospel. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. And now we join our voices together to confess our Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated as we sing Lift High the Cross.
Thank you.
your family, your friends. Grace and peace be unto you from God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. What is the measure of a woman? I think it's possible that if you ask 10 different people that question, you would get close to 10 different answers. I really like the answer given by legendary actress Audrey Hepburn. She says, "The beauty of a woman is not in the clothes she wears, the figure she carries, or the way she combs her hair. True beauty in a woman is reflected in her soul. It's the caring she lovingly gives, the passion she shows, and the beauty of that woman only grows with the passing years." By this rubric, Carol was an exceptional woman. Born and raised right here in North Dakota, Carol was loved by her children, her grandchildren, and her great-grandchildren. Like many women who lived on the farm, and that includes my grandma and mom, she knew her way around the kitchen. You knew her well, I bet you remember eating her ham and buttered noodles. She was very active in the church and was frequently seen in the sewing group and at Bible studies. Unfortunately, I got here right after Carol moved to Somerset, so she wasn't contributing to potlucks at that time, but I have it on good authority that Carol's dishes were some of the first people would sample during a potluck. She was a warm, caring person, and she'll be missed by many. Now, I don't think the Bible disagrees with Ms. Hepburn's words at all, but in God's Word, we see another facet of our lives in this world. King David says in the 51st Psalm that all of us are sinful from the time we are conceived. Scripture goes so far as to say that we are dead in our trespasses and our sins. In other words, in our sinful flesh, we could never measure up to God's holy standards. That being said, in his letter to the church in Ephesus, which is one of our readings for this afternoon, the Apostle Paul writes, "Because of his great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive with Christ even when we were dead in transgressions. For it is by grace that you have been saved through faith. This is not from yourselves, it is a gift of God, not by works, so no one can boast." So we hear that salvation comes through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. In Christ, we find that we do meet God's standard. But not all are saved. So what's the rest of the story? Well, I left a really important detail out of Carol's narrative. In fact, it's such an important detail that nothing else I said would mean anything without it. I'll share it now. On December 11th, 1932, Carol Padal was baptized. She was baptized at then Bloomfield Lutheran Church in Upham. God's Word promises that through this baptism, he saved us. Not because of works done by us in righteousness, but according to his own mercy. This is Titus chapter 3. By the washing of regeneration and renewal of the Holy Spirit, whom he poured out on us generously through Jesus Christ our Savior. So that having been justified by his grace, we might become heirs according to the hope of eternal life. Paul says this saying is trustworthy. In baptism, we are washed clean daily. We are defended against the deceits of the devil. Carol knew this very well. But our good shepherd, the very shepherd that we heard about in that reading from Psalm 23, wasn't content to give Carol just one precious salvific gift. And so he regularly came to her in the Lord's Supper in his true body and true blood, assuring her that she belonged to Christ alone. Here from 1 Corinthians chapter 10, Paul says, "The cup of blessing that we bless, is this not a participation in the blood of Christ? This bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because there is one bread, we who are one body, one flock, we all partake of the one bread." Carol regularly received this gift from our Lord after her confirmation on November 24th, 1945. And she would receive that gift for strength and peace until the very end. In fact, I'm not sure how many of our Somerset ladies we have in here right now. Certainly we have some. I saw you already. One of the great joys of my time here as pastor is that my wife and I get to go once a month to Somerset, and we have a worship service with all the ladies there. So I was able to worship with Carol just a couple of weeks ago. And she was beaming as she always was. In preparation for the message this morning, I had a passage from Scripture jump out at me, and even though I don't like to make last-minute changes, I threw it in there. I wanted to incorporate it because it's so comforting. At the beginning of Romans chapter 5, and this is a section of the Bible I share frequently when I'm in the hospital, the Apostle Paul says, "Since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ." That sounds pretty nice. But Paul follows this by telling us that we rejoice in our sufferings and that God brings good even through these hardships. Now, you might disagree with me, but I don't know anybody who likes suffering. I don't know anybody who enjoys pain. But we have to admit that coming through suffering often does bring us closer to God. Carol grew up during the Depression. She lost her husband, Owen, suddenly in 1996. It was a long time ago. She understood suffering. And yet Carol was full of joy. If you knew her for a day, you know how true that is. That joy spilled out into the lives of those who knew her, and I'm sure most of us have a great Carol story that we could share. I would encourage you to do just that during the fellowship time after the service. Now, it's significant to me that Carol herself chose the hymns and the readings for the funeral service today. She picked some really good ones. Some really good ones. The first song that we sang today is often called "It Is Well With My Soul," although the hymnal calls it "When Peace Like a River." Regardless of what you call it, it's a very comforting hymn. It's very appropriate for this occasion. I want to take just a minute to highlight the third verse. I know you just sang it, but let's hear it again. It says this: "He lives." Who lives? Jesus lives. He lives. Oh, the bliss of this glorious thought. My sin, not in part, but the whole, is nailed to his cross, and I bear it no more. Praise the Lord, O my soul. Carol lived in the hopeful expectation that she would one day be with her Savior forever. That day has come, and we rejoice in her salvation. So what's the measure of a woman? That's the question. I think there's a whole lot more that we could say about Carol. A whole lot more that you're not going to hear from me, but hopefully we'll share with one another. She was active in 4-H and Cub Scouts. I was never in the Scouts, but I did 4-H my whole life. That's awesome. She was always present here at the church for sewing and Bible study. She was so proud of her family. She had such a giving heart. She loved cats and dogs. Even the mangy, sickly ones that would show up at her doorstep, she would nurse back to health. I see some heads nodding. Carol was a caretaker. And she was always looking towards the needs of others. But the true measure of Carol Padal, she was a baptized child of God, and she will spend eternity with our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, friends, I know that death has connotations. Death is loss. Death is sad. Death is an evil foe, according to the word. It's the last foe that we face in this life. That applies so well to Carol's confirmation verse. Her confirmation verse was Joshua chapter 1, verses 5 through 6. And God says this to Joshua: "Be strong and courageous. I will not leave you. I will not forsake you." That applies so well to modern believers as well. None of us can measure up to God's holy standard on our own. But as David says in the 23rd Psalm, our good shepherd has prepared a table for us, even in the midst of our enemies. In Christ, we more than meet the standard. Carol now understands that perfectly, as will we when we join her that one day with Jesus in eternity. And now may the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus alone. Amen. At this time in the service, we go to our Lord in prayer. I'll allow you to stay seated. Go ahead and stay seated for this part. But after each petition, I'll say, "Lord, in your mercy, please respond with your own prayer." Let's pray. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Give to the whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Lord, in your mercy, grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and so pass with him through the gate of death and the grave to our joyful resurrection. Lord, in your mercy, give courage and faith to the bereaved, that within the communion of your church they may have strength to meet the days ahead, in the assurance of a holy and certain hope, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love who have departed in the faith. Lord, in your mercy, receive our thanks for Carol and for all the blessings you bestowed on her in this earthly life. Bring us at last to our heavenly home, that we may with her see you face to face in the joys of paradise. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. And now in the words of our Lord, we pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Carol, a sheep of your fold, a lamb of your flock, a sinner of your redeeming, a daughter and heir of eternal life through faith in Christ. We thank you that you have received her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of your faithful people for all eternity. Amen. Before the benediction, I just have a couple of things I want to share with you. We would invite you to join us down the hall in the great room for bars and coffee and good conversation and fellowship. I'll say a brief prayer for that fellowship in just a moment. We're also going to be having a committal service right here in the sanctuary following the funeral. So during that closing hymn, we'll just stay put, and then after that hymn, we'll begin with the committal. Let's pray for that time of fellowship. Gracious Father, we thank you for the food and drink that loving hands have prepared for us today. We pray that our time together would be blessed in your sight. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Receive the blessing of our Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. We'll sing On Eagle's Wings. Thank you. continue with the service of committal. Often the service is done at graveside, but certainly not all the time. When you have a good reason, as we do today, it often directly follows the funeral. I like that because it's a chance to see a service maybe you've never seen before. We'll begin with prayer. Merciful Father and Lord of life, with whom live the spirits of those who depart in the faith, we thank you for blessing the body and soul of our departed sister Carol, whose earthly remains we lay to rest. Above all, we rejoice at your gracious promise to all your servants, both living and departed, that we shall be raised from death at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We have a reading from John chapter 12. Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Truly, truly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Whoever loves his life loses it. Whoever hates his life in this world will keep it for eternal life. If anyone serves me, he must follow me. And where I am, there will my servant be also. If anyone serves me, the Father will honor him." And a reading from 1 Corinthians 15, Paul writes, "Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we shall be changed. For this perishable body must put on the imperishable, this mortal body must put on immortality. When the perishable puts on the imperishable, and the mortal puts on the immortality, then shall come to pass the saying that is written, 'Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting?' The sting of death is sin, the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ." We now commit the body of our sister Carol to its resting place, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, and the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, who will change our lowly bodies so they will be like his glorious body by the power that enables him to subdue all things to himself. May God the Father, who created this body, may God the Son, who by his blood redeemed this body, may God the Holy Spirit, who by holy baptism sanctified this body to be his temple, keep these remains to the day of the resurrection of all flesh. Amen. We pray. Almighty God, by the death of your Son, Jesus Christ, you destroyed death. By his rest in the tomb, you sanctified the graves of your saints. By his bodily resurrection, you brought life and immortality to light, so that all who die in him abide in peace and hope. Receive our thanks for the victory over death and the grave he won for us. Keep us in everlasting communion with all who wait for him on earth, with all in heaven who are with him. For he is the resurrection and the life, even Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And receive this blessing again. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you his peace. Thank you.
always in a good mood.
Something else.
Pleasantly confused. She was pleasantly confused sometimes.